So, panie i panowie, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Ella Air. Good morning, nice to have you here.
Hi, it's lovely to be here, thank you.
Well, first of all, I've seen a lot of your live performance on YouTube. However, one really needs to go to your show, to your gig, to see and feel your voice. Girl, you have a huge voice.
Oh, thank you. The thing is with live, I don't know, there's a whole new thing. You just sort of come to life. I feel like people always say to me that I look like a lion, and I like to think that lion is like my alter ego when I play live. And I learned a lot from being on top with the Rudimental Boys about energy and you know, connecting with an audience on stage.
Oh, definitely, Miss Lioness on stage. Did a huge show last night. And tell me, how does it feel? Because you're 19 and you're like standing on a stage like yesterday, and you see, you know, a huge crowd of people literally crumbling each other to see you and to hear you better, to be closer to you. How does that feel? Because I wouldn't know.
I don't know. I don't really think about it when I'm there. I'm just sort of flat that there are people in front of me. It's just really, I don't know, it's just a really lovely vibe. I've never been to Poland before. And so to have that reception, for the first gig that I ever do was really nice. And it's just really flattering to be here and to have that kind of reaction.
Have you had any Polish food?
I have, yeah. Yesterday we had all this lovely gourmet Polish food, but I'm a big fan of the dumplings.
Oh, like everybody, that's a traditional Polish cuisine, definitely. And when have you realized that singing is something that you really want to do, like professionally?
I think I realized when I was probably about 16. It wasn't long ago. I've always enjoyed singing, but I just never really took it seriously. And it was only when I was in school and I was cast as Tallulah and Bugsy Malone. And it's like a musical theatre show where you sing and act. And that's when I learned that I enjoyed performing. I think I learned that I enjoyed performing before I learned that I liked singing to crowds. And so it just happened quite naturally. But I just love being in front of an audience, being able to interact and, you know, and communicate with them.
And when can we expect your LP? In summer?
Yeah, in the summer, yeah. We're looking about September, but maybe a little bit earlier.
Okay, fair enough. And what about collaborations? Because you started with a really good single, Deeper, and then you had like a lot of collaborations with Bastille, with Rudimental, obviously, amazing hit. And can we expect any collaboration surprises on your album?
I think it's a little bit too early to say, you know, like the album's written, but it's just, we're still in production stages, like experimenting with things, because some of the songs are quite old. I started writing about 3 years ago, and so we're trying to bring it up to speed with the newer stuff that I've written. And so it's a little bit early to say in terms of collaborations, but I do personally feel like this album is about establishing myself as an artist, and, you know, I've done a lot of collaborations, and I think I need to sort of branch out on my own for a little bit.
People can be divided into morning people and night people. And what kind of a person are you?
Probably neither. I'm like a middle day person, because I don't like getting up, but I don't like going to bed early, kind of thing.
Okay.
And I don't like going out too much. I do, but like on the odd occasion.
Okay, so do you eat breakfast or brunch?
Brunch.
Brunch, okay. And how do you like your brunch?
For works, bacon, eggs, beans, all that.
Okay, typical English, right? And do you like eating your brunch at home, at a different, I don't know, outdoors or in bed?
Oh, in bed is the best, but that never happens anymore. but probably out, because I'm out. I'm already up and working by the time it comes to brunch.
I can sense your style and everything, but how would you describe your style yourself?
I like to think that my style is sort of like relaxed and sort of sexy. Like, I think one of my influences would be somebody like Lana Del Rey. You know, she always wears like really simple but really sexy and casual clothes. And I don't know, I'm not that experimental yet. You know, I've only sort of just got into the whole fashion thing. My mum used to be a fashion designer, so she's more into it than I am.
So you're even close to that subject.
Yeah, I'm close to it, but I think it drove me nuts. I think it winded me up more than I enjoyed it when I was a kid, because my mum would always put me in these ridiculous outfits and think I look really cute.
And now everybody's envying you.
Oh, well, I don't know. I mean, I guess I do get to look at fashion in a different way now.
And do you shop online in stores? Do you have a stylist?
All three. Like, I love going shopping, I have a stylist, and I do like shopping online as well when I don't have time to go out.
Okay, fair enough. And I have a question that, a tricky question. Do you ever swim in a swimming cap? How would you put all this in a swimming cap? That was like, I thought about
it. You don't. I've never tried, actually. I don't think it would work.
Yeah, one more thing I wanted to ask you. Because we have one thing in common. Well, definitely singing, it's not that what we have in common. But I noticed you Instagrammed a photo of a person pointing a gun at a Cupid trying to shoot him with an arrow. And I once posted the very exact photo on my Facebook, yeah. So I wonder whether you posted it because it was funny and, you know, you perceived it more as a joke, or do you really feel that, you know, love should wait for you?
I just think at the moment I'm 19, I don't need that. I'm just sort of...
So you're pointing the gun.
Yeah, I think I'm just being a bit cynical about, you know, relationships. I don't know, I mean, I guess I've just come out of a long one, so I'm just kind of like, I'm being selfish, I'm looking after myself.
Oh, I should high five you.
Absolutely.
Okay, girl, so I wish you like all the best. I wish your album to be a total hit, and I believe it will be. Your voice is amazing, and I'm looking forward to seeing you the next time you come to Poland.
Thank you, I can't wait to come back.
Thank you very much.